What's good, y'all? It's your girl, Jakayla A, and we back with this very pretty set. It's giving Valentine's Day, but I do believe it was her birthday. We got our girl Jess in. She used to come in 2020, and she stopped getting nails done, period. Like, she just told me she stopped getting them, and then she wanted to come back for her birthday. So, we gonna get her right. We got our Santa being on a very low speed, even though this is moving fast. It looks like it's fast. It's on the lowest possible speed it could be. We're only trying to remove the shine and the oil off the nail bed. And it's a very light hand I'm using. We're cutting down the nails. I love to cut down the nails underneath. If the client requests to keep them, I do let them keep them. It's no issue at all. Then we're going in with our cuticle bit. And then we're going to nip off our dead skin that is hanging off. I cut that out so you couldn't see it, but she had quite a bit because she wasn't getting nails for a long time, so that's to be expected. She uses a C-curve tip because she has like a dome nail bed. They lay beautifully on her nail bed, but I did switch in 2021 to a non-C-curve tip pre-shape for my other clients because most of us have a flat nail in my, you know, experience with my clients. Like me, I got a flat nail, so I don't feel like the C-curve, this harsh C-curve, is the most flattering if you have that type of nail. But she has a dome nail bed, and they just, woo, they fit so pretty. So I love this tip cutter trick with the magnets. I think I talked about it in my last video, but if you got any questions, just let me know. You could always go on TikTok and look up like tip cutter magnet, whatever, but just ask me if you got questions. It makes for time saving. And then I'm blending in my tip with the natural nail bed. Once again, it looks like I'm doing it so fast and so rough. But it's a low speed and I have a light hand. It's not doing all that. Now, the thing about Jess is that she's one of my clients that know how she like her nails. I don't want to call her picky because it's just so negative to say that somebody is picky. But if you're not looking at it negatively, she is picky. She is not bad picky. She's particular. That, there you go. That's the word, particular. She's particular about how she wants her nails to be. And I feel like people get such a negative rap when they not just like a sit down, do whatever type of client, which I do have those. Believe me, I have those and I appreciate them. But way more of my clients, the majority, overwhelming majority of my clients are going to have a say-so in their nails and are going to want to know what their nails are going to be like. They come in really pretty much with a picture inspiration, or they come in and they want to collaborate with me like I just was with her. That's why I kept that footage in. So you always want to accommodate in your timing for your services, the consultation. You're going to sit, you're going to talk to them, you're going to examine their fingers, you're going to, you know, like her, I haven't seen her in 2 years. I'm going to sit, I'm going to talk about her life, what she's been doing, her nail bed health. I'm looking at everything, I'm examining everything. She hadn't been getting no nails. It looked like she hadn't had no nails in a long time. Everything was perfect. And then a part of that is how you want your nails done today. So I was just watching products and we just going through it. She decided that she liked some, didn't like some. And we ended up with a marble nail, a plain nail, an ombre nail, a nail with some art on it, and a nail with some encapsulated pieces. Boom. And then we did the same thing on the other hand. So it's not bad if you're the client. It is not bad to have a say-so in what you want. You are spending your money. If it's not even your money, if your boyfriend gave it to you, if your sugar daddy gave it to you, if you found that shit on the street, if your mama gave it to you, I don't care. You have a right to have a say in how you spending your money and speak up in real time in the moment so that there's no confusion. I kind of prefer when people know how they want their nails done, because if you do a freestyle and they don't like it, they might go and blast you, or they might come after the fact like, I didn't like this, or they might wait for you to do it and then be like, I didn't like this. So it's a little catch 22 with that sometimes. You might want to you might find a beauty in a person that just know what they want. So we can make sure everybody's happy here. A person that just know what they want is something refreshing about it. And it's not like she's being rude. It's not like any of my clients ever was rude to me. They just had a direction. And that's okay. So I just want to say that to the clients. You don't got to be the freestyle sit down. My nail tech know me. She always lay me. I don't even got to tell her what to do. She just do it. Because eventually you do learn your clients like that. And I do have some of those. I probably got like 3 of those. Okay. And that's not a lot for the clients I got. 3 is a very small amount in the clients that I have that would just let me do my own thing. I got like three of those people, and everybody else pretty much they be knowing what they want to a T, and that's okay. It is completely okay to know what you want. And if you're the nail tech, accommodate for that time. Accommodate for that time in your service. You should be having a consultation in your service with your client anyway.
There will be tears, I've no doubt. There may be sighs, but a few.
I don't know how I feel about talking during the application. I feel like the application is the time where I'm gonna not talk in the video. I don't know, y'all let me know, because I could talk all day in the video. But I feel like the application part is just like kind of the most therapeutic part of seeing nail videos, because I used to watch them all the time, and now, you know, I still watch them here and there when I can catch them, because I just be so busy. But basically, we did a marble nail that had to be capped. We did a white nail, it had to be capped, because I do not like leaving my white nails uncapped. With this formula, and this white is from Young Nails XXX, white. It's a super white, very pretty, very clean, but for whatever reason, I do not like leaving it uncapped. So, and my, thumbnail was, I think it was like a mixture of two powders, and it was marbling just a little bit. It still ended up cute, but because of that, I capped it. So all of these nails were laid down, and then I had to go in and cap it in clear. And that was just like so new for me. I feel so nostalgic doing that, because I don't do so many encapsulated nails no more. You know, I keep up with the trends. How the trends move is how I move. So yeah, that's just not really what my clients are asking for these days. So I just feel like this was a throwback. I don't know. Y'all, I put at least 52 beads on this thumb. When I tell y'all to not be hung up on beads, that's what I mean. If it takes 3, cool. If it takes 13, cool. Period. So I'm going in with my 80-80 grit file. Gotta make sure that you buff the edges so you don't cut your clients. That's a pro tip. And make sure your posture is right. Good posture makes for good shape. Bad posture makes for bad shape. That's on your part and the client part. I'm going in on the sides and over the top with that. Don't get too close to the cuticle area with your file. You have a e-file for that. I always buff the skin because for whatever reason, I get acrylic on the skin. Oh my God, I hate it so bad. But it's easy to buff off. And then here I am sealing in with my 5-in-1 bit. I only show one application, one filing because like I said, we did the same one. Look how happy she is. Period. I'm so happy I'm getting my nails done. That's the type of reactions I want to see out of my clients. That's all that matters. That is all that matters. I always do a rub down with oil, get the cuticle. I rub down the surface. It's every bit of a 15 second, but it's a little bit more like luxurious. And I'm gonna do pictures and they know I am. So definitely gotta wipe off the nail with alcohol to get the oil off so it's not dull. And it's just a little treat on the service. And that's it, y'all. That was the whole service. I really like this set because pink is everything. Catch y'all in the next one. Bye.